Trouble deepens for Karnataka Chief Minister Siddaramaiah. Governor Thavar Chand Gehlot on Saturday sanctioned his prosecution in the alleged Mooda scam. Siddaramaiah vehemently denied all charges, dismissing them as politically motivated vendetta against him.
I will fight it out legally in a court of law because it is an illegal sanction given by the governor, who is a puppet of the central government. There is no prima facie case against me or against anybody. And the BJP has no moral right to ask my resignation.
The row erupted after RTI activist TJ Abraham lodged a complaint accusing Siddaramaiah of concealing critical information about land holdings in his election affidavit. The complaint centers around land owned by Siddaramaiah's wife Parvati, who is alleged to have benefited from land swaps. The Mysuru Urban Development Authority, or MUDA as it's called, allotted Parvati land in prime locality as compensation for the land that was acquired from her, which was much less in valuation. The RTI inquiry suggested illegal manipulations and corrupt practices in the land allocation process, sparking demands for the cancellation of these plots granted to Parvati.
Without knowing the Mailaraya son and daughter, he is giving the letter to UD and he took the denotification and he changed his khata also in corporation, revenue department, okay, in the name of Devraju. Then 2004, he sold the property to Parvati brother.
Incidentally, the allotments happened during the BJP rule in the state.
Under the provision of the PC Act, I'm not supposed to directly come to the governor. But there is a circular which is resulted, it's an outcome of an order passed by the High Court. That circular mandates me to append the copy of the sanction along with the complaint.
The political fallout was immediate. Congress Chief Mallikarjun Kharge quickly flew to Bengaluru to support the embattled Chief Minister, rallying the party in his defence.
The BJP government is acting on Chief Ministers and Ministers wherever the other governments are there. The BJP governments, they are always harassing, humiliating the Chief Ministers. But I will see what exact reason is in this.
In Mysuru, Congress leaders staged a protest with chants of "Go back, Governor." Congress workers hit the streets in Chikmagaluru too, protesting against prosecution nod by the governor. Deputy Chief Minister D.K. Shivkumar branded the governor's actions against Siddaramaiah as unconstitutional.
Ella jilla kendragalallu kuda Congress pakshada karyakartara mukhandaru rashtrapatigalige avaru representation kalisikolta idare. Ivattu prajaprabhutvada ondu kaggole dodda sarkarana issue illade avarna issue madakke ivattu hortidare. Gandhi tattva namdu shantiyinda ನಮ್ಮ ಪ್ರತಿಭಟನೆಯನ್ನು ವ್ಯಕ್ತಪಡಿಸಿ ಈ ದೇಶಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂದು ದೊಡ್ಡ ಸಂದೇಶವನ್ನು ಕಳಿಸಬೇಕು.
ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅನ್ಫಾರ್ಚುನೇಟ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೀಕರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ದ 10th ಶೆಡ್ಯೂಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದಿ ಆಫೀಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಗವರ್ನರ್. ದೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಥಿಂಗ್ ಬಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟೆಬಿಲೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಅಟೆಂಪ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಬೈ ದ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್, ಬೈ ದಿ ರೂಲಿಂಗ್ ಪಾರ್ಟಿ, ಫಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರ್ ಯು ಹವ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್, ಡಿಸ್ಟೆಬಿಲೈಸಿಂಗ್ ಗವರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರ್ ಯು ಹವ್ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಮಾಡೆಲ್ ವಿಚ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಇಸ್ ಸೀನ್ ಟ್ವೈಸ್ ಅರ್ಲಿಯರ್. So I condemn it with all the force at my command.
The opposition BJP has seized the opportunity to demand Siddaramaiah's resignation.
Protest karna chahiye, Bhrashtachari Siddaramaiah istifa dena chahiye. Aisa protest hona chahiye, kyunki Siddaramaiah do case mein avikalpit hai. BJP mang karti hai, turant Siddaramaiah istifa dena. He should resign immediately.
Whatever the decision taken by the Honorable Governor, it is within the legal purview and 100% within the legal ambit. And whatever the Congress people always criticizing.
As the political battle intensifies, the allegations of corruption places Siddaramaiah in a precarious position with legal challenges now looming over his political future. The coming days will be crucial as the Chief Minister and his party navigates this deepening crisis.